Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. Someone sent me a message. Maybe they sent me an email or a message on LinkedIn. I don't know. But they said, hey, Patrick, we're using DirectQuery when we create our Power BI reports, but we have RLS, role level security, in the source. What do we need to do? Do we need to create roles in Power BI Desktop? Can we take advantage of the roles that's in our source? Let's say the source is SQL Server or Azure SQL, doesn't matter. How do we take advantage of the role level security that's built there? And it got me to thinking, I was like, this is a good video idea, so I'm gonna do a video on it. But I also thought, what happens when you have role level security in the source and you do import? Well, you know how we like to do? Instead of all this talking, I gotta show you. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So what I did was I created a DirectQuery model, and you can see now I'm signed in as me, and there's security in the source that limits my access to the data to only sales territories that are not the United States. There's another user that I've created and implemented role level security for John Doe, and John Doe can only see data that is for the United States, okay? With DirectQuery and my role level security, I'm hoping that when I sign in, I see data that's not the United States, and when John signs in, he sees data that is the United States because of the role level security in the source. Let's see what happens. So I published this out to Power BI, and then you can see here's the report, and here's the data set. So I'm gonna go ahead and open the report as me. Perfect, it's beautiful, it works. And then what I'm gonna do is, I'm signed in as John Doe in this web browser. I'm gonna go ahead and open this report because I've given John viewer access to this workspace, nothing higher than viewer. And I'm gonna open this up. Let's do a quick refresh. Maybe it's cached. John sees the same data as me. That's a problem because we want to use the RLS that's in my Azure SQL database. How do I fix that? So what I need to do is go back over to my workspace, go to my data set, that RLS DirectQuery and source, go to settings, go to data source credentials, click on edit credentials, and you see there's gonna be a checkbox that says report viewers can only access this data source with their own Power BI identities using DirectQuery. Let's check that. Click sign in, go ahead and get signed in as me. Now I'm authenticating as me, but I'm also checking that box. So it's gonna override my credentials. If John signs in and views this report, it's gonna run it under his Power BI identity. It's gonna send his Power BI identity back to the source and execute those queries as such. Let me show you. So if we go here, let's run the report here. Let's do a refresh just to make sure. Me, right? So let's go over here for John. And you can see I'm signed in as John. And let me run the report now. Now we see the data for United States just by checking that box. So if you want to leverage the role level security in your source when you're using DirectQuery, you need to make sure you check that box so it'll pass that user identity back to the source and run the queries under the context of that user. But that's one thing to consider when you have RLS in your source. What about when you're using import? So if I go to Power BI Desktop, you see I've created a model. Remember, I have role level security in the source activated for me. I only see international data in this blank row, right? And I publish this out to the service, head back to the service under my context. And what I'm gonna do is do a refresh on that data set. Now the refresh is finished. Let's go take a look at that report. So I'm gonna go over here. I'm gonna choose that RLS import. Beautiful. Let's do a refresh to make sure there's no caching involved. It's for me. I only can see the data that's not the United States. What do you think is gonna happen when we open the report for John? So we're gonna go over to the web browser where I'm signed in as John, go to that RLS report. Let's do a refresh. Let's be fair. Let's do a refresh. What happens is the refresh is running under the context of Patrick. Patrick only has access to Australia, Canada, France, and on and on and so forth, but not United States. So when it reaches back to the source, it runs that query under the context of me and pulls only the data that I can see into the import model. And that means anyone that accessed that model that has access to it will see that data. So how do you fix this? One thing you can do is create an account that you're gonna use to authenticate back to the source that has full access to the data. And if it has full access to the data, then you build a role that uses role level security in the import model that mimics the role level security in the source, limiting the data for John to just the United States and limiting the data for me for just the other countries. You create that role in the model, publish it out, add those people to that model. Make sure you don't give them more than viewer access, and then it will control the data. And so you got to be careful when you're using role level security in the source for both import and direct query. What do you think? Do you want to know more about role level security? If you do, there's two things you should go check out. I have a whole playlist that will fly up at the top. And we have a full course on role level security that you should check out. And if you have any questions or comments, you know what to do. post them in the comments below. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.